Today we are going to go over how to use WOWJS in React. So if you've ever wondered how people get those cool animations like this, it's just a super easy way to add this into your website. Obviously this is a little like redundant, but it's just to show off all what the ease of WOW can do and kind of help you out to make your life a little bit easier. So I went ahead and already just made a very simple website with some photos and a hello world and all that, just to save some time. Hopefully you already have a project that you want to apply this to and you're ready to go. So the first thing that we are going to do is install WOWJS. So I'm just going to say WOWJS npm. Gonna go here, and this is just the WOW info. It's the documentation. This takes you to that place that we were just on. All right, so here we're going to do npm install WOWJS. So go to your terminal and whatever project that you're gonna work on, navigate to there. So mine's on right now, so I'm going to get out. So I'm going to say npm install, and then I do a capital S just to save it locally so it doesn't accidentally do it globally or have to reinstall it later. So WOWJS. All right, there it goes. Great. Okay. So another piece to the puzzle that we're going to need, as you see here, it says dependency animate.css. Okay, and then we're just going to take this link here, the CDN, and we're going to put it in our index.html. So go ahead and go to your open your favorite text editor and navigate to your project. So I'm going to go into the public folder, and I'm going to go to the index here, and I'm just going to paste it in the head, just like normal. There we go. All right, cool. Go back. Okay, let me get my notes up here. All right, cool. So let's go ahead and go to content. So this is where all my content lives. And the first thing we have to do now is import WOW, all capitals, from WOWJS. And then above render here, we have to do a component did mount. Sorry, you have to call it. There you go. All right, and then you just say new wow dot wow, and then call it dot init. Okay. All right, so that kind of, that activates it there. So, to have a little bit of fun, it's super easy now. So to get an idea of what kind of animation that we actually want, we can look at, so animate.css. We can kind of look at all the different animations that they have, like built in. If you want it to do a jello, bounce out effect, I mean, there's a whole bunch of stuff in here, whatever you want. Let's say we're going to do this flip in Y. Okay, so we go here and go to wherever you want to add your thing. Let's say we want to add it to this hello world here. So I say class name equals, let's see, I have to say wow. And then Let's see, let's just double check the documentation. Alright, so we say wow, and then we say the effect that we want. So in this case, I want to flip in y. Okay, and then there's all of these different sort of directions that you can give it. You can have like wow duration, delay, offset, iteration. So let's say I just want this data wow iteration 10 times. Let's say I want this to happen 10 times. All right, cool. All right, so hypothetically this should work. Oh, oops, right, we have to start it again. There it goes. Now it's going. And it's going to do that 10 times because we told it to, which can be a little excessive. Most times you won't want to do that. You probably only want to do it once. There we go. Okay, all right, so now we can have some fun adding on to these things and such. Kind of one of my favorite effects is creating sort of like a delayed effect with these images. And that can happen pretty easily. So let's go ahead and add to our class names the wow. And let's just say we want fade down. Let's say we want the fade down. That's one of the animate CSS ones. So they all have the same thing. Okay, let's say data wow iteration equals 1. Let's see, data wow offset equals, so what offset does is that depending on where this is in the page, like as you, okay, it's going to reload, as you scroll, depending on where you are in the page, it'll then activate, because I don't want it to be activating it the second the page loads, because then the viewer would never be able to see the actual animation. So let's say, it's also kind of like, think of it kind of like view height, like how far down it's going to be. So I want it to be like 80% down. Cool, and I don't want a delay on that. Well, actually, yeah. Okay, so then we can also do wow. Oops. Data wow delay equals, and I'm just going to do 0.5s. So half second delay. See, is this okay? Just make sure it works. Maybe fade down isn't one. Just do a flip and y. Yep, okay, cool. I just misspelled that wrong, so we'll just do flip and y. Well, that's not what we really want, is it? Fade in down. Okay. Okay, so we have that all set, so now we're going to add it to the other ones, but we're going to have a delayed effect. Well, I only want this one time. Data wow offset equals 80, because I want it to happen at the same time, but I want it to be delayed. That this is the key. let's say 0.75 seconds. Okay, and then let's do the same to here. Data, wow, iteration equals 1. Data, wow, offset equals 80. Data, wow, delay equals, oh, 1 second. Okay, all right, cool. So let's see what's gonna happen. Okay, whoop, okay. So let's refresh that so we can see it from the beginning. There it is. And then whoop, just falls in just like that. It's kind of fun. Watch it again. So this can just kind of add a little bit of class to your website. It's pretty fun to do and it's really easy. Doesn't take a lot of legwork on your part. So yeah, so I really hope that this helped you out and it made WOW.js in React a little bit easier for you. All right, well, we'll catch you later on the next one.